So starting with the next point, that is fuzzy sets. What is this fuzzy sets? We have already seen that fuzzy set is the extension of what? Is the extension of classical set theory. When we say classical set theory, we have already seen in the earlier lecture that this particular classical set theory means the crisp set. And what is the crisp set? Crisp set is whenever we have the membership function which is always either 0 or 1, either true or false, then we call that particular set as the crisp set. But what to do when we have a varying degree of membership? Whenever we have a varying degree of membership, I mean to say the membership which is lying between 0 and 1, at that particular time we are going to use the fuzzy set theory, right? So a logic based on the two truthful values, true and false, is sometimes inadequate when describing the human reasoning. So when we talk about real world or real life problems, the answer is not always 0 or 1. It is sometimes confusing. It has certain probability, certain characteristics on the basis of which we are going to take the decision. So there we are going to use the fuzzy set theory when the membership function, the degree of membership, is varying between 0 and 1, right? Now, fuzzy set, I have defined a fuzzy set as any set that allows its member to have different degree of membership. That is what I told you earlier, which is called as membership function. Membership function, what is membership function? Defining the value whether the element belongs to a particular set or not. But when I say in fuzzy set, it means the degree of truth in the set. How much truth value does the element have for a particular set? So the degree of membership or truth is not same as probability. It is fuzzy truth is not likelihood of some event or condition, but it represents the membership in vaguely defined sets, right? In further slides, we are going to see certain examples in which we will be able to understand this concept. Now, fuzzy logic is derived from fuzzy set theory dealing with reasoning that is approximate rather than precisely deduced from predicate logic. That means we are going to deal with reasoning and which does not give you an exact answer or exact input. It is imprecise. It is holding up the uncertainty. Fuzzy logic is capable of handling inherently imprecise concepts. That is what I told you. Fuzzy logic allows in linguistic form the set membership values to imprecise concepts like slightly, quite, and very. When we say whether it's cold or not, it's not either yes or no. When winter starts, we say it's slightly cold today. It's quite cold. It's very cold, right? So we are defining the degree of truth value of the set cold. Fine? So this is being described in the linguistic form. So this is what all about of the fuzzy logic. Now, when we represent the fuzzy set and the crisp set, what is the difference between these two? See, we have taken an example of height, whether a person is tall or not. When we say in the terms of crisp set, what it is, in terms of crisp set, this is the point where crisp set is defined, and here it is fuzzy set which is defined. Crisp set will have a specific value, so it is defined that 1.8 is the height below which the person is not tall and above which the person is tall. But that is not the right way to define a tall person, right? So this will be how defined? This will be defined at this place the person is not tall and at this place the person is tall, right? So 1.8, below 1.8 the person is not tall and above 1.8 the person is tall. So this is how we are defining the degree or grade of truth. This is the crisp set. But when we talk about fuzzy set, we have taken 1.8 as the concept of height calculation, but we are taking certain margin that if a person is slightly lesser than 1.8, even then he is considered to be tall. He is slightly tall. He is approximately tall. He is not that tall. So this particular margin, you can see this. This is what? This is giving you a slight margin regarding the height, which is slightly below and slightly above the 1.8 height. But in CRISPR, it is exact and it is accurate at 1.8. You can see the straight line. So this is how the set is being represented in degree of grade of truth in terms of CRISP and in terms of fuzzy, right? This is what we have defined. If it is below 1.8, if it is 1.79, this is going to belong to both to tall and also to not tall, fine? 1.8 is going to belong to tall as well as not tall. But in CRISPR, it is going to belong to not tall only. Now, fuzzy sets. What are these membership functions? Membership functions, I already told you that whatever value we are assigning to the element of the universal set, that specified range defines the membership grade of that element, right? Now, whenever the value of membership function is large, that means it has the high degree of set of membership. A set defined by membership function is a fuzzy set. The most commonly used range of values of membership function is the unit interval. And what is the unit interval? We know that is 0 and 1, 0, 1. So we are taking, let X be a universal CRISP set, fine? X will always be a CRISP set. Now in this, when we define the membership function of a fuzzy set A, X is a universal set, which is a CRISP set, but when we are defining the fuzzy set A, it will be denoted as mu A. This is how we are going to represent this. You have to learn how we are going to represent it as this. The mu A is the membership function of set A, where capital X, that is the CRISP set, is belonging to 0 and 1. This is the unit interval. Fine, this is how we are going to define it. Now, what I am going to tell you, what does this mean? Larger values denote higher degrees of set membership. See, in this what we have, this is how we are going to represent A. A is a fuzzy set. This is a fuzzy set. How we are going to represent the fuzzy set? As the notations we were using in CRISP set, this is X is an element of set A. The membership function of X will be defined here. That will be given in the braces. This mark is used. This is not a division mark. This is just a slash mark. X, where this small x is going to belong to the universal set U, right? If U is a collection of objects denoted generically by X, then fuzzy set A in U is defined as a set of ordered pairs, fine? So I have told you how we are going to define set A is equal to element X. Membership function of element X is going to be defined out here, which is denoted by mu A bracket X, and it is this X is going to belong to mu, right? Now this is the notation we are going to use. Now what is this mu X? Mu X A is going to belong to the range of 0 or 1. Mu A, that is membership function of X, belongs to 0 to 1, any value, fine? Here we can see the example. I have taken a mu for young set. This is what? This is defining that this is giving you an example of A, that here it is young and it is going on and then it is decreasing as the age increases. This is not the perfect example. I've just vaguely given a graph out here. So, showing you here. See, universal set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. A. Now, 1 is X. 1. Let's take it this way. This is, let it be X1. 2 is X2. 3 is X3, 4 is X4, 5 is X5, 6 is X6, 7 is X7, and 8 is X8. let it be the elements. Now when I define the membership function of x1 is what? It is 0.1. This is the membership function of A. How it is represented? Mu A brackets x1. And this is what? This is x. Fine. So you can just see. Now this is what? This is x2. That is 2, value 2. And mu A x2. That means membership function of 2 is 0.3. 3. This is x3 element. And membership function of x3 is 0.8. Now let's understand what this set is all about. This set is trying to tell you 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 are the elements, and we are defining the degree of honesty among these. So 1 is having the degree of honesty that is equal to 0.1. 2 is having the degree of honesty as 0.3. 3 is having the degree of honesty as 0.8. 4 is having the complete honesty as 1, right? So as the value is greater for membership function, that defines the degree of truth is higher, right? When we say rate, scale it on 0 to 1. What does 0 means? The lowest. And what does 1 means? Highest. So membership function which is having the higher value is having the higher degree of truth. So 4 is having, among all these, 4 is having the highest degree of truth in the honesty, with respect to honesty. This is how we are going to see, show the graphically. We are going to show at 1 it is 0.1, at 2 it is 0.3, at 3 it is 0.8, at 4 it is 1, and so on and so forth. So this is how we are going to define the discrete universe. These are the alternative notations. This we can just understand. We have already seen discrete is defined by summation, while continuous is defined by integral sign. And this is what? This is the membership function. We have already seen this is A is a fuzzy set, X is the element, and this is the membership function of element X, and X belongs to universal set. Fine. These are certain properties which we are going to see in further lectures, and we will see, we will use it wherever it is needed. It is same, almost same as the crisp sets. That's all for today's lecture. Thank you very much.